Hello friends, we are here again to discuss the advantages and disadvantages of a group in our 10 minute short lecture. Now this question is again very important from the examination point of view. We must know the advantages and disadvantages of a group. Now this automatically comes as we read down the group dynamics, but however we'll be separately dealing with these now. Let's see one by one what are the differences between advantages of the groups and the disadvantages of the groups. Advantage of the group. Group brings together people for a specific purpose, right? Disadvantage is some group's specific purpose may conflict with the objective of the organization or with those of the other groups, right? So this can lead to problem. Groups generally achieve positive synergy. That means they can achieve 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. That means individual contributions, when collectively done, can multiply the output. Right? So this is positive synergy. Group disadvantage of the group can be, it may lead to negative synergy, especially when disruptive behavior, ambiguous roles are there, or interpersonal conflict between the group members are there. So there can be negative synergy, especially when the groups, there is conflict within the group. The groups are fighting with one another, fighting within the group is there, ambiguous roles are not clear to the individuals. Interpersonal conflict is there. So in such a case, there will not be a positive synergy, but there will be a negative synergy, and as a result, the objective of the group to enhance the work performance would be defeated. Again, another advantage of the group can be, groups can become highly cohesive and high performance entities. So they, groups can achieve high performance, right? This advantage is there, but there is a disadvantage in this category also. Group can become highly cohesive but can work against the organization's goals, or that means the group can work against the organization. It can be cohesive, but it can work against the organization. This may lead to a problem to the organization. Okay, so this can be used as positively if they are working together for the organization. It is good advantage, it can be taken as an advantage. But if the entire group is working against the goals of the organization, they are trying to achieve some other goals, or they are completely going against the goals of the organization, they can be disruptive. Individuals can collaborate to achieve a joint goal. Now in the groups, individuals can combine together and they have a same goal, so they can group themselves together to achieve this goal. In a group, some people may be in a position to loaf while others do the work. Group social loafing can be there. Now what is social loafing? Social loafing means in a group when certain people do not do the job, they think that the others will do the job, and they simply loaf away, or they simply travel away, or they simply lazy out and do not do their work, their piece of work. Now that is called social loafing in a group. So social loafing in a group can be there, and this is a disadvantage of the group if there is social loafing in a group. Now another advantage of the group is group of people with complementary skills, attitudes, experience, viewpoints may enhance the task accomplishment and decision making. Now if the group is there where there are different attitudes, there's different skills of the people, Now we have also discussed the Belbin's 6 team rules. Now if all the Belbin's 8 team rules, now if all the 8 team rules are present in the group, that means the group can work very effectively and do all the jobs. So different variety of skills are required and experience is required so that the group can work and collaborate and form a synergy. Now but if the group is not of such type, the disadvantage, if the group is with the people of similar opinions and viewpoints, may make uncreative or poor decisions, while the group of people with extreme differences or with strong subgroups may experience dysfunctional level of conflict in decision making. Now so if the group is there and the group is having similar viewpoint of people, then the decision will not be correct, right? Poor decision will be there. Now if there are people with extreme differences, there will be strong sub, or there are strong small groups within a group, subgroups within the group, and they are fighting with one another. So it will be very difficult to achieve a decision in such a case. So this can lead to a disadvantage of the group. Okay, now let's look into some other advantages of the group. People from collectivist society like to work well in a group. So collectivist societies like India, etc., they like to work in a group. Now people in European society, especially America, UK, etc., they are individualistic society. They like to work alone. They do not go well in the groups. Now there the groups will not work very well. Another advantage of group is organizing people into groups clarifies goals and activities and enables people to work together on large and complex tasks. Okay, now disadvantage can be there in here also. More people are organized into specific task related activities, the more they become different from other groups working on different goals and activities, leading to problematic intergroup relationships. Now, the more the people are organized into smaller groups, the more the groups become, there is more of conflict within different groups. Right? The groups start fighting with one another. This again becomes a problem for the organization. Okay, another important point is group can be an ideal collection of people to work on a particular task. Ideally, people are collected and they work on a task. Or there can be wrong group size, might not be right. This can be a disadvantage. Combination of people might not be correct to achieve a particular task. That might lead to inefficiency of the group, and that group might not react well. That means the combination of the people are not very good. If they are ideally connected people, then it may lead to an advantage. If they are not people who are connected together, they cannot combination of people to achieve a task, they are not right people to achieve that particular task, then it can lead to a disadvantage. Another difference between the groups is informal groups can enable informal networks of individuals who support one another towards achieving organizational goals. Informal groups can have members whose goals and behaviors conflict intentionally or unintentionally with organizational goals. One is an advantage, another is a disadvantage. Disadvantage is informal groups can have members whose goals and behaviors conflict intentionally or unintentionally with one another. So this can lead to a disadvantage. This is all about the advantages and disadvantages of the group. This is how we can use the group for advantage of the organization or disadvantage. That is all in this lecture. Thank you very much.